Rivers of Illinois, Mississippi, Illinois, Wabash, and Ohio. Ecology, physical factors. The rivers in Illinois are home to people, plants, and animals. Historically, many settlers chose land close to major waterways to build their communities. Sites close to rivers had much appeal to early settlers for the many resources and opportunities they presented. The four main rivers in the state are the Illinois, Mississippi, Wabash, and Ohio. The Illinois River runs 332 miles connecting northern Illinois to the Mississippi River. Some of the major cities along it include Ottawa, LaSalle, Peru, Peoria, East Peoria, and Pekin. The other three major rivers define much of Illinois' borders. The Mississippi River acts as a 581-mile western border with Missouri and Iowa. Major cities along it are Moline, East Moline, Rock Island, Quincy, Alton, East St. Louis, and Cahokia. The Wabash River makes up a piece of the eastern border between Illinois and Indiana, and this section is 230 miles long. It passes by Palestine and Mount Carmel. The border of Illinois and Kentucky is defined by the Ohio River, which runs 133 miles along the southeastern part of the state. Cities along this river include Rosecleare, Golconda, Brookport, Metropolis, and Cairo. Ecology is the scientific study of relations that living organisms have with respect to each other and their natural environment. In this podcast, we will focus on the physical factors of rivers. In particular, we will look at characteristics like drainage basins, current, temperature, size, pollution, flooding, human alterations, and sedimentation. Drainage basin. The total area of land that contributes water to a river or a stream is its drainage basin or watershed. Precipitation that falls in a river's drainage basin will flow downhill and into that river. The Illinois River has a drainage basin of 18,566,400 acres of land from Illinois, Wisconsin, and Indiana. The Mississippi River drains over 30 million acres in Illinois alone. Overall, its watershed covers areas of 31 states and two Canadian provinces and is the third largest in the world at 768 million acres. This drainage basin covers 41% of the United States. The drainage basin of the Wabash River is much smaller, draining 5,496,500 acres in Illinois and 21,062,400 acres overall. The Ohio River has a drainage basin of 7,079,680 acres in Illinois and 121,230,080 acres overall. Current. A current is a steady flow of water. A river current flows due to gravity and goes from the drainage basin towards the sea. Therefore, as a river flows, it continually lowers in elevation. The big rivers in Illinois have large elevation drops from their source to their end. The Illinois River's start is at the confluence of the Kankakee and Des Plaines rivers. Its elevation here is 505 feet above sea level. It flows southwest until it meets the Mississippi River at 417 feet above sea level. The Wabash River follows elevation changes to the lowest point in Indiana, where it flows into the Ohio River. Here, the elevation above sea level is 370 feet. The Ohio River joins the Mississippi River at the southern tip and lowest point of Illinois at 315 feet in elevation. From the origin of the Mississippi River to its end at the Gulf of Mexico, there is a 1,475-foot drop in elevation. This huge drop keeps the current flowing south towards the ocean. At the Mississippi's headwaters, the water speed is 1.2 miles per hour. Closer to New Orleans, Louisiana, its speed is much faster, around 3 miles per hour. Temperature. Since water is constantly flowing in rivers, the temperature of a river is constantly changing. The speed of the water, how much of it is exposed to sunlight, and its volume all affect a river's temperature. In general, the temperature of Illinois' rivers range from 32 degrees Fahrenheit in January to 77 degrees Fahrenheit in July. Rivers sometimes completely freeze over, usually when there is extremely cold air in place over an extended period of time in combination with low water flow. In the 1800s, people along the rivers would harvest large blocks of ice from frozen rivers and keep them in an ice house until the following summer when they needed them. Huge blocks of ice were packed in sawdust, usually in underground chambers within the ice houses, so they would remain frozen. Today, however, the Mississippi, Illinois, and Ohio rivers have plentiful barge traffic and a defined navigation channel so that large rivers are much less likely to freeze. It is common in the winter months, though, to have chunks of ice floating down these rivers. Size. A major physical trait of a river is its size. The size of a river can be measured in several different ways. The Illinois River is 332 miles long and with its adjoining backwaters provides 87,000 surface acres. The term surface acre is a measurement of the amount of land covered by water. On average, it is 23 feet deep. The Illinois River's mean annual flow before it joins the Mississippi is 22,560 cubic feet per second. The Mississippi River has always been known for its great size and was thus named Mississippi, meaning Father of the Waters in the Algonquin language. The Mississippi River is the third longest in North America at about 2,400 miles. It borders Illinois for 581 miles. By volume, it is the fifth largest in the world. At its headwaters at Lake Itasca, Minnesota, the river is between 20 and 30 feet wide and about 3 feet deep. In New Orleans, Louisiana, where it meets the ocean, the Mississippi River is 4 miles wide and about 200 feet deep. At its headwaters, it has a 6 cubic feet per second flow, 46,000 cubic feet per second flow at the northern Illinois border, and 600,000 cubic feet per second flow at the Gulf of Mexico. In Thebes, in southern Illinois, before the Ohio River joins it, the average annual discharge of the Mississippi is 204,000 cubic feet per second. The Wabash River is 475 miles long, with 230 miles in Illinois. It begins as a small stream and becomes the Ohio River's largest northern tributary. Its average flow is 30,400 cubic feet per second. The Ohio River contributes more water to the Mississippi River than does any other tributary. Its width is just over a mile and its flow is around 281,000 cubic feet per second when it meets the Mississippi. Pollution. Pollution is the introduction of contaminants into a natural environment that causes harm to an ecosystem. Pollution is an aspect of the rivers that affects everyone and everything in and around them. Pollution can come from many sources. The main pollutants of Illinois rivers are metals, silt, nutrients, and suspended solids. Most of these pollutants are due to agricultural practices, habitat changes, municipal and industrial discharges, and contaminated sediments. The largest contributing factor to river pollution in the state is agricultural runoff, which causes nutrient pollution. When soil from agricultural fields is carried by streams or floods into the rivers, the water is also carrying the fertilizers and pesticides farmers use on their crops. These fertilizers in the river are the biggest contributing factors to nutrient pollution. Having such high nutrient concentrations in the rivers leads to more algae and phytoplankton, which are digested by microorganisms, a process that removes oxygen from the water. One of the major effects of this is the dead zone in the Gulf of Mexico. This is an area of water that does not have enough dissolved oxygen to support life. The size of the dead zone at the mouth of the Mississippi River has been increasing due to increases of pollution in the rivers. Flooding. A flood occurs when water overflows from its source onto previously dry land. Flooding is a natural process for rivers, and many rivers flood regularly. A floodplain is the low-lying land next to a river that is covered in water during a flood. When a river floods, it leaves nutrients and rich sediments in its floodplain, increasing the productivity of the land. A floodplain can contain 1,000 times more species than the river itself and can be a very profitable area for agriculture due to its nutrient-rich soil. Flooding tends to occur in spring and early summer. Cold winters cause freezing and excess water is stored as ice or snow. In spring, thawing releases the water and may cause flooding. Spring and early summer also tend to be times of the most precipitation in the state. There are four levels of flooding: action stage, minor flood stage, moderate flood stage, and major flood stage. In the action stage, the water surface is over the top of its banks, but no man-made structures are flooded. During a minor flood stage, few, if any, buildings are expected to flood. Water may cover roads and parklands at this point. When an area is in a moderate flood stage, roads are likely to be closed or cut off, buildings begin to be flooded, and evacuations are possible. The most significant flooding is classified in the major flood stage. These floods can be life-threatening and cover extensive areas. Structures may be completely submerged in water, and there are large-scale evacuations. Many actions have been taken to try to control rivers in order to prevent flooding in Illinois. Changes like levees and locks and dams have decreased the natural flooding cycle and lessened the productivity of these systems. A levee is a long, continuous ridge built by people along the banks of a river to try to contain the water as a set channel, especially during times of high flow. By keeping the water contained, people hope to prevent flooding of the adjoining land. This action results in higher water that flows faster than it would naturally. More water moving faster can cause problems for areas downstream and put more stress on their flood control systems. The Mississippi River levee system is one of the largest in the world, with 3,500 miles of levees. On average, levees are 24 feet high on the Mississippi. Levees along any river can fail. A levee breach is when part of the levee breaks away, so there is an opening for water to flood through the floodplain land. In times of high floods, water may even surpass the tops of the levees to flood the land. Locks and dams. Other physical changes to the rivers result from lock and dam systems and channeling. In order to meet necessary navigation standards on the Illinois, Mississippi, and Ohio rivers, lock and dam systems have been put in place. A dam is a device like a wall that is used to control water levels to allow river navigation to occur year-round. A lock is a gate system to permit boats to pass by the dam and place them in the appropriate water level upstream or downstream from the dam. Mississippi River navigation by barge requires a 9-foot deep channel and a minimum width of 400 feet. The Mississippi River has 14 locks and dams along the Illinois border. Along the Illinois River, there are 4 locks and dams. Unlike the other rivers, the part of the Wabash River that is in Illinois has no locks or dams and instead flows freely. The Ohio River has 4 locks and dams on its Illinois segment. Erosion and sedimentation. Erosion is the process of weathering and transport of solids like sediment, soil, and rock in their environments from their source to other areas. Natural erosion can be caused by wind, water, or glaciers. Sediment is the material that is broken down by these processes and is transported by the rivers. Sedimentation is the tendency for particles to settle out of the fluid in which they are contained and come to rest against a barrier. Human interventions on the river have greatly accelerated the processes of erosion and sedimentation, making them some of the most difficult and unmanaged aspects of the rivers. Each year, 13.8 million tons of sediment enter the Illinois River. Of that total, 5.6 million tons enter the Mississippi River, leaving 8.2 million tons of sediment a year in the Illinois River Valley. Most of this sediment is deposited into backwater lakes along the river. These lakes are quickly filling up with sediment and have already lost 72% of their original capacity. The Mississippi River carries 436 tons of sediment a day, 159 million tons a year. Sedimentation creates issues with water quality because river water is often used as drinking water. The presence of particles in the water makes it less transparent. The more particles suspended in the water, the murkier it becomes and its quality worsens. Then it is harder to treat and make the water clean enough to drink. Sedimentation can also clog navigation channels by depositing too much sediment in them. Peoria Lake on the Illinois River is the largest and deepest bottomland lake in the Illinois River Valley. Peoria Lake has lost 77% of its water capacity and the average depth of the upper part of the lake is only 2 feet. It has been dredged multiple times in order to maintain its navigation channel. In 2004, the Mud to Parks project dredged 105,000 tons of sediment from the lake and transported it to make a park on the Lake Michigan shore. Sedimentation is problematic for humans and wildlife, especially aquatic life. Besides losing habitats in the quickly diminishing backwater lake, sediment can cover and suffocate fish eggs and insect larvae, as well as clog and damage gill structures. Physical factors of the river help to determine what can live in, on, and around the rivers.